Hello students, welcome to Vidwa Niketan. Are you ready for today's class?
Hello guys, welcome to Vidya Niketan. In this video, we are going to discuss about the syllabus of ICSE Class 8 Mathematics, because it is very important to discuss the syllabus first before we proceed for any learning. So that's why in this video, we are going to discuss the syllabus in detail, and whatever the chapter you will have in your course material, we will discuss all the things. Okay. So the first, these are the blocks of chapters like number system, ratio and proportion, algebra, geometry, mensuration and data handling. So these are the name of the main course chapters that you need to study, and under all these chapters there are lots of other chapters that you need to learn basically. So to learn in a particular way, you must follow the syllabus, because it is very important. Yes, you can learn out of the syllabus also, but first you need to learn what is in the syllabus, because if you don't know what is in the syllabus, then the study is just a normal thing. It will not give you any result. Okay. So first we will discuss in detail, that is rational numbers. In number, there will be various chapters. So we are going to discuss in 1, 2, 3, 4 in this sequence. So first chapter will be on rational numbers, then properties of rational number. Then we have simplification, and we have rational number on number line. We will discuss each and everything in next videos, but for now just go through the syllabus. Next we have square and square roots, then square of numbers, square root using factor method, square root using division method, square root of decimals and square root workout. So these are all in your square root and square syllabus. Then we have cube and cube roots, then finding cube roots by factorization, cube roots and workout, then exponents and powers, negative exponents and laws of exponents or negative exponents, and practice. Here you see this word practice. It is very important for your mathematics learning, because every day we will just give you some practice problems and all these things. Just you need to solve those, and in the next videos we will discuss the solution. So it is very important you just do whatever we are doing and be with us, and you will understand each and every point. Okay. Now playing with numbers, then number game and divisibility test. It is also a very important chapter, because divisibility is a very important thing that we need to learn, because in next classes, like in class 9 or in class 10, whenever you are going to give the board, the divisibility is very important. Then we have set. It is again a very important chapter. Here only in class 8 you will only have the basic introduction about sets. But after that, you have lots of operation in sets. So if you know the basics of sets, then those will be easier for you. So that's why sets, then subset, superset, operation on sets, then operation on sets and workout, then Venn diagram, then cardinal properties of sets. So all this we will study. Now, 7, comparing quantities, ratio and percentages, profit and loss workout, and compound interest PL, direct proportion and inverse proportion. Then we have algebraic expressions and identities. Here it is a very interesting and important chapter that we need to follow, that is addition and subtraction of algebraic expression, multiplication of algebraic expression of monomials, multiplication of algebraic expressions polynomials, multiplication of algebraic expressions. Then we have to do practice, then algebraic identities, applying identities. So one more thing I just need to tell, for identities we will do lots of identities there, and I promise no problem will be there whenever you are trying to solve any identity afterwards. Okay. So now the next, factorization, again a very important algebraic chapter, factorization of algebraic expression using identities, factorization of algebraic equations, splitting the middle term. This you will do in your whole life if you are in the science related field. Middle term is a very important thing. Then we have factorization workout, then linear equations, then why it is called linear equation, all these we will be in detail. Then linear equation is in one variable, linear equation what problems, linear equations in one variable, then again what problem. So in this way the problem and sessions will be going on for this chapter. It is a very important chapter. Then we have inequalities, again important, linear inequalities, then solving linear inequalities. Then we have quadrilaterals, a very interesting chapter where you will learn a lot of things about graph, then quadrilaterals, and the most important thing is we will also give you the visual of the graphs, like how the expressions are being presented in the graph itself, like in coordinate geometry how you present all the things. We'll discuss each and everything in detail. Then types of polygon and angle sum, property of quadrilateral, then polygon angle sum, properties of parallelogram, properties of special quadrilaterals, application of properties of quadrilaterals. Then this is a very important geometric chapter. Each and every thing we will discuss, like in graphs also, because quadrilateral it is a normal Euclidean geometry, but also we will use each and everything in Cartesian also. So just so that you can relate that. Okay, now we have representing 3D in 2D, different views of a solid shape, elements of a 3D figure, faces, edges and vertices. Then practical geometry, construction of quadrilaterals and workout practice problems. I am already repeating you, the practice is the very important key whenever you are trying to learn mathematics, because unless any other subject where you can learn before the day of the exam, in this particular subject you cannot do that. You have to be in regular practice if you want to achieve good marks. And the most important thing is marks are not the most important thing, but the thing is learning. That however you are learning and like how you are learning, if you have any problems there, if you have any problem in concept and each and everything, you can discuss with the comment section, and each and everywhere we will reach to you. Now we have reflection symmetry, then we have circles and in parts, properties of circle, then we have mensuration, then perimeter and area of combination of figures, then trapezium, rhombus and general quadrilateral, area of polygon, solid shapes, then surface area, volume and all these things we will study. Then we have data handling. It is a just I just want to tell you, it is a very basic part of statistics. So we will do that because it is very important. In your later classes you will have to do all these things, and if you are trying to, like if you want to take science in your afterward in class 11 and 12, the statistics part is a very important part. So you have to understand the basics first. So these are the basics. Now we have coordinate geometry that I have told earlier in the quadrilaterals part, that we will also relate to the coordinate geometry. So this is the coordinate geometry, Cartesian plane and line graphs, interpreting and drawing linear graphs. So all these we will study. So till this the syllabus is completed in detail. Now two more thing, like books preparation and studies and strategy. So books we will prefer, that is Concise Mathematics by Selina Publishers. It is a very standard book, because many problems you will face in your examinations from this particular book. And the next book, it is a very fundamental book, that is Foundation Mathematics for ICSE School book 8 by RS Agarwal. If you can, then please buy these two books or arrange PDF from anywhere of these two books, and keep these books handy because it will need whenever you are practicing. Now again, our strategy, like you have to solve previous year papers, but don't worry guys, we will provide each and everything, like previous year paper and each and everything we will provide. And one more thing, that I will take another separate video about that, like special learning curve. There is a one perception, if you follow the learning curve you will learn each and everything. So this way the first video is completed, and if you have any queries about the syllabus you can obviously contact us. Do any comment in the comment section and we will obviously see that. So thank you for watching Vidyaniketan. We will meet in next video. Thank you so much.